Well, it's time to find my inner outlaw. Take these guns down from my ship. I'm gonna find out where you've been drinking. Stand behind as you choke on your last drop.
At home with Tracy and the Big D. Joining us now is Rory Ellis, and his brand new single out is called Inner Outlaw. And I am pleased to say it is number 32 this week in the Country Songs Top 40 charts. Congratulations, Rory. It's starting to make its way up there.
Well, thank you very much, Tracy. We're very excited. It's amazing. Brilliant. I found out a little later today and I was like, oh, wow. So, very excited. Thank you so much.
Yeah, and obviously you're getting a good reaction from the audience out there. We're not getting too much with an audience at the moment, but you're getting some good feedback?
Yeah, absolutely. I think because I guess the content's a little different.
Very much. And you know what? That's what shows a lot to people. The album is called Inner Outlaw, and this is the track that we're playing at the moment. But some of the songs that are on there, you know, you're looking at Bitumen Cowboys and The Letter. Such a diverse change in songs. Is that the way all the way through the album?
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, look, you know, there's another song there called 53rd Year, which is my old man passed away when he was 53. And I, at the time I was approaching 53, I thought, ooh, this isn't cool.
Close for comfort.
Yeah, that's it. I thought, well, I made it through anyway, so it's good. You know, I'm all good now. So I made it to the other side safely. So that's the main thing. Yeah, you know, look, you know, it's like songs like What Happened to That Man, which is, you know, I guess old school fellow who used to wear the hat and a tweed coat and, you know, was a gentleman and all the rest of it. You know, he was happy to be a hard worker, and that was all cool. And you know, there was none of that. You know, I've got to shave my back sort of stuff. He was just a regular fella. It was a case of, you know, what happened to that guy? You know, as you know, songs come to you when they come to you, and all sorts of things trigger the reaction. And this album, I guess, in many ways, I always love the Waylon Willie, Johnny Cash thing. You know, I was raised on it with my dad. I guess more than anything, I always loved that whole outlaw country movement because they dared to be a little different and dared to do things that weren't so establishment-like. And, you know, I guess this album was, from the outset, was my little spin on the whole outlaw country movement. It's always going to be a little different to that, naturally, because it's me, but I think we got it across the line, Tracy.
Your vocals also lend itself to the outlaw style as well.
I've actually been very chuffed to find out that many people think, oh, gee, sounds like Waylon. Mm. And I'm going, oh, that's nice.
Now, come on, the film clip. We have to talk about this film clip. It is exactly what I thought we would see in the film clip after listening to the song. I mean, you get everything in it. But come on, that must have been so much fun doing it.
Oh, it was. Look, it's pure spaghetti. It's very Bud Spencer, very Clint. We've got it all in there. We've got everything from you know, the Wilhelm scream to Blazing Saddles to the Clint squint. It's all there. And it was really just a, you know, dare I say it, a bit of a joke, really, on the whole spaghetti western thing. And I loved it. I just think it had to be done. You know, it's just one of those things that there's a lot of videos out there with cars and countries and old houses. And, you know, I thought, yeah, this could be a bit of fun.
Seriously, it is a fun little video. Get out there. It's Rory Ellis, Inner Outlaw. And you get Rory where he's all serious and he's, like, going to do some harm here. Then all of a sudden he's doing a little dance. A little jig, and in that cheeky little smile comes out as well, right through to the dramatic gunfight at the end.
Honestly, Tracy, they can't miss the shovel dance. You know, the shovel dance is just something else. It's just my moment in the sun, that one.
It is so nice to be able to have a little bit of a laugh in these times. The hands are down at the moment. So what's Rory Ellis doing in some bit of time out musically?
I've actually been doing a lot of writing, to be honest with you. I think since the album was released, I've now written close to another 30 tracks.
Wow.
Just sitting there in the archive, and you know, we hope to put out another album, I reckon, probably next year. And in the meantime, in putting together a little band and doing all that sort of stuff, you know, when we can, well, now we can start to rehearse a little bit, so that's good. So we've been working hard on that, and as of last night, my darling girl managed to book a couple of shows with the Black Sorrows at Lazotte's in November, so that's going to be fantastic. Really looking forward to that, and that'll be the first gig almost. It's just everything just went so quiet. And, you know, we were just left there twiddling our thumbs, and things are moving back slowly. But I guess, you know, we just got to be careful as we can move them back slowly but surely. But, yeah, I'm really looking forward to that. And but it's been doing that. And apart from that, you know, growing a lot of vegetables, really.
We've been watching. We saw the lovely curry last night.
That was awesome, I tell you. I do a good satay type curry here.
Ah, right. So we know where we're going for dinner when we're down your way.
Absolutely.
as you mentioned there, you're doing a lot of writing. Has the situation and the times changed your style of writing?
Look, I guess me being me, Tracy, you know, yes, I could have written loads about COVID-19, but I think I chose not to. I don't really want to sit there and write songs about it. I've chosen to write other things. You know, like there's a song there, which is a song called Uncle Jimmy's Table, which was actually almost like part two of the letter, because many years ago, my Uncle Jimmy, he too was a concreter, and he built this table out of marble chip. It was an old chess table. And that old chess table was where my grandfather used to sit and drink beer with people like Arthur Caldwell and Bob Hawke in his little backyard in Porter Street, Paran. Yeah. You know, those sort of things to me, it's got to mean something to me to write something about it.
And I think that's the thing that we've been thanking all the artists from across all genres of music for, not letting the music die. They've been releasing new music, getting the stuff out there, and we've had a few comedy ones lately too, and I think it's just great that we can have a bit of a laugh in such shitty times, I suppose you could call it.
Oh, look, yeah, look, if we lose our sense of humour, we lose everything, don't we? That was probably the best time. It's the litmus test for, you know, the sense of humour as such, you know.
Well, if people want to take a little bit of a light-hearted look at the world today and check out your video clips and things like that, what's the best way for them to do it?
Look, the best way for anybody to get in touch with me or have a look at the video, Trace, is obviously the website, just roryellis.com.
But even some of the backorder stuff that Rory's got on there, and have a look what he's been doing over the years. Support another Aussie artist. They're out there doing it tough. Maybe, as I said to our last guest, maybe the people at home, because we're listening to a lot more music at the moment, when you do get back out there and start singing again, Rory, let's hope they're singing your lyrics straight back to you.
That'd be great, wouldn't it?
Sure would. Rory Ellis, thank you very much for joining us. The new single out at the moment is Inner Outlaw. Check it out, guys.
I'm going to stop your train right in its tracks. Gonna drag you to Boot Hill, dig you in deep, yes I will. Well, it's time to find my inner outlaw. I'm gonna shake him